The world champion Rio Kyoshin is from Japan, the twice world champion. She beat her earlier this year, so she's really on form.
Yeah.
But coming onto the tatami first is Viviana Botaro, 30 years old. Her coach is Roberta Cedero, who in her own time was a brilliant karateka in Fukata.
And Kumite.
Yeah,
she won the championship in kata and Kumite. One of the few who did both titles.
Well, Sanchez will be wearing blue. She'll be coming out second, and it will be Botaro who will start with her kata, which is Super Empe. The athletes have to perform a different kata in each of the rounds. She had a bye in the first round, and was her chosen kata in the second, and died in Chetanyara Kushanku. Super Empe from the Shitoru School of Karate. Two specific areas for judgment, five judges, each with a red and a blue flag. At the end of the kata, they will assess the performance against the two major criteria, which is technical performance and athletic performance.
Very good start, very powerful, good speed.
As you can see, the kata has explosive, quick movements and then pauses for slow execution of technique. Stances, Sanchindachi. Quick turns. Very impressive, Dominic.
Yes, he has good change of speed and slow techniques without doing stops. There's no reason, so the rhythm is very good.
In the technical aspect of the judgment, we assess for the transition of the movement, the techniques, the timing. Hara, the stances.
Yeah, the precision of the stances is very important, and you can see the feet are really good on the floor flat.
Very, very good. Excellent execution of the jumping Toby Maigari to come to the end of the performance of Super Empe. Viviana Botaro from Italy, world ranked number 6. She leaves the tatami. And we await Sandra Sanchez.
Three.
three times European champion, current European champion. She's going for her fourth consecutive European title. The chosen kata is Apure.
Yeah, both athletes are very technical and high standard, but also physical, athletic performance is very good. So the difficulty of the kata is very important also in this final. Could maybe do also the difference in both.
In some katas, stamping the feet is deemed to be a foul, but in Papurin there are specific areas of the kata where that is required. Oh, this is very, very good, Dominic.
Yes, it is. She had a good change of direction, with a good speed and control of the body.
And she completes the kata Papurin, having already performed Kuala Lumpur, Mandai, Suparempe and Anand on the way through to the final.
Papurin has more difficulty being one leg to stop after the Maigarit.
And the degree of difficulty of the kata is a consideration. So, Daniel Brunner from Switzerland, Paul Tante, and it is a 5-0 decision in favor of Sandra Sanchez of Spain, who takes her fourth consecutive European title.
Sandra Sanchez is
like I said, maybe the difficulty of the kata was chosen better from Sanchez also. And could make the difference of the decision.
Can be indeed. With fast turns, excellent performance. She really is on form. Going into the World Championships later this year in Madrid, in her home country. She's absolutely delighted with her performance, as will be her coach.
But we have to say also, Pocaro, last year she came back on a higher level. Make big progress, I think, for her. For many years she's here on the top level and course.
And it is indeed the same final as last year, because it was both Pataro and Sanchez who were looking for that win, and it went to Sanchez, and she's taking the gold medal and the European crown once more.
Ali, so